All right, so this is going to be a quick look at this ASUS VivoBook S15 S533F notebook PC. So the customer had this weird issue where it wasn't detecting the SSD unless you kind of put pressure or bent the laptop in a certain way. So here's just a quick look inside. I ended up not being able to record the disassembly, but you use a T5 or Torx 5 screwdriver to get all the little silver screws on the bottom out. There aren't any hidden screws. And then once you do that, if you've watched my other videos, I use my fingernails in the gap where the cover goes, and then I push with my thumb on the palm rest to pop the clips out, and you can get that out. You start with the palm rest, like the front area, then you go around the sides, and then the back you kind of lift the cover up, and then you kind of wiggle it to undo the clips. Don't try and pry out the clips from the back. All right, so anyways, let's go ahead and take a look inside. All right, so here's what it looks like inside. You can see the RAM is soldered to the motherboard. You do have the removable wireless card. You got the battery there, removable, obviously. It has one of those little sliding metal things that you have to slide back a little to pop the connector out. I've actually worked on a lot of laptops with this design, so if you need to see a video like that, just let me know. Then it has an M.2 PCIe NVMe SSD. So hopefully you can figure out what's what inside. You also have a little daughter board on the left that's removable. CPU is soldered to the motherboard, if I didn't already mention that. The charge port does look to be removable in the top right corner. There's a disconnecting, there's a connector there. And then you also have the LCD LVDS connector there. All right, and not much else. The speakers aren't held in with screws. You can pop them out. They are connected with a red and black wire along the front of the laptop. And then there's one connector to the top or towards the right center of the laptop. Okay, and yeah, the fan also is removable, obviously. Okay, so not really much else to talk about there. The laptop was weird, I think, because they dropped it. There's probably a crack in the motherboard somewhere, or maybe the SSD connector or something. But if you're holding it up, the laptop by one corner, the weight of the rest of the laptop causes the case to kind of go in a arced like shape, where it's the higher point is from where you're holding, and then it curves down and the lower point is where you're not holding. And that was causing the laptop to go to like the BIOS and not detect the SSD. The way we got it to actually detect the SSD, we basically had to hold the laptop up by one side and then push down with your thumb, basically flexing it the opposite way, so curving it like a U instead of like a A, yeah, shape. So you basically want to put pressure. You put one side down on the on a table, then you push, you lift up the other side and push down with your thumb to basically curve it somewhat like a U. You don't want to push too hard, but that got it to work. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the battery, and then we'll wrap it up. All right, so here you can see the battery model number is C31N1905. Pretty simple to replace. You just remove the screws holding it down, and then again the connector, you slide up that silver part, and then you can actually pop the white part of the connector up. I just get my fingernail underneath and pop it out. Again, I do have videos showing this, so if you need that, just let me know. But yeah, other than that, sorry I couldn't get a full video. I couldn't really get a video of this one because the customer was there and wanted me to do it quick. So yeah, but other than that, that's pretty much it. Hopefully this 3-picture slideshow helped. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.